Learn more on BBC Bitesize.
Calculating percentages is something you should be confident about. Here's a couple of hacks to make them easier and faster to solve. Firstly, when asked to find a percentage of a number, here's a handy trick for you. Swap the numbers around. So what's 14% of 50? It's tricky, right? But if you swap the numbers to work out 50% of 14, this will give you the same answer. 50% of 14 is 7, and 14% of 50 is also 7. Pretty cool, right? It's all because x percent of y gives you the exact same answer as y percent of x. And this method will work with any percentage conversion. 12% of 75? Swap it round to 75% of 12. And now you need to find 3 quarters of 12, which is 9. And 9 is also 12% of 75. Okay, here's another hack that's very useful when increasing or decreasing a value by a percentage. It's called the decimal multiplier hack. Every percentage has an equivalent decimal value. If your favourite shop sends you an email offering you a 20% discount, you can use this hack to work out the new price of an item you want. To decrease something by 20%, you multiply by the decimal equivalent of 80%, because 80% is 20% less than the original amount, 100%. 80% as a decimal is 80 divided by 100, which equals 0.8. Let's say that £40 top you've got your eye on is reduced by 20%. You have to multiply 40 by 80% as a decimal, which is 0.8. 40 times 0.8 equals £32. And to increase by a percentage is similar. For example, train tickets often go up in price during peak travel times. If you wanted to increase a value by 30%, you need to multiply by the decimal equivalent of 130%, as this is 30% more than the original amount, 100%. 130% as a decimal is 130 divided by 100, which equals 1.3. So if we want to increase 80 by 30%, you have to multiply 80 by 1.3, which equals 104.
For in-depth GCSE resources and practice, visit BBC Bitesize now.